Hello, my name is Denis and I tell you about Russian football. Today's topic is winter football. As you know, Russia is a very big country. 11 time zones, this is no joke. From north to south, the country ranges spanning about 4,500 kilometers. The climate is different in the different regions of Russia. For example, the first part of the season 2018-2019 finished in the early December. The second part has been starting in the March 1st. The weather of the many non-south regions is cold and snowy in these months. If the air temperature is below minus 15 degrees Celsius, a match will be cancelled. There are several options to solve this problem. For example, a match can be postponed to another date. Or home-away matches can be switched. In cold weather, there will be a match at the stadium of the southern team, in warm time at the stadium of the northern team. Do you understand me? Of course, there are special people who created the season calendar. And these special people do their job poorly, constantly, every year. Russian ironic proverb. Winter has come suddenly in December. But now the quality of the football pitches or football fields is better than 20-30 years ago. In those years there were mud wrestling in bad weather, not football. Let's watch this video. Russia, Italy and Buffon. It was a great Gianluigi's debut. So, professional football teams have vacation in winter. But there are non-professional teams and special tournaments for these teams. For example, the annual Winter Championship in St. Petersburg. A few days ago, I worked as a commentator of several matches of this tournament. Let's watch this video from stadium. I arrived at the stadium. Weather is fine. This is Petrovsky Sport Center. Big Petrovsky Stadium is a former home of FSC Zenit. But I am going to the small Petrovsky Stadium. Small Petrovsky Stadium, Neva River and Fisher. Today non-professional teams play matches of the Winter Championship of St. Petersburg. I am going to comment two semi-final matches for the YouTube channel of the Football Federation of St. Petersburg. Защитники вновь перепасовываются друг с другом, но они делают это не так часто, как защитники некоторых других команд. Опять возвращаемся к поединку «Катюша-Звезда». Там вот каждая атака практически начиналась именно с таких перепасов.
That's all. Game over and I'll go home.
Brrr, it was cold, but funny. Meanwhile, the second episode has come to an end. You can ask questions in the comments below this video. Subscribe to this channel and you will not miss next videos. Goodbye and sorry for my English.